So hey all, this is Shubhankar here from Consapp. So in this video, we are going to understand some type of, I would say, non-directional first and oscillating strategy, and then we'll try to understand some of the strategies which can be used when we are expecting a volatile movement in market. So we will try to understand that. So in the previous videos, we had understood about the bullish strategies, the bearish strategies. So similarly, in this video, we are going to decode some of the strategies using Quantsapp. So first, we'll understand a volatile type of a strategy wherein, now let's say if there is a budget which is going to be announced. Okay. Now, during the budget, like let's say we are standing on the budget day itself, we know that that news is going to affect the market either positively or negatively. We don't know whether the market is going to move up or move down, but we definitely know that market is going to move, let's say 100, 200 or 200-300 points on the up or the downside. It is going to move definitely for sure. Now, that is not possible if we go ahead and take a futures trade, because we can't go ahead and buy and sell the futures of same contract, right? So ultimately, using options, we can try and tackle certain type of scenarios wherein we don't know where the movement is going to happen, whether on the upside or the downside. A breakout is definitely going to happen, but we don't know the direction of it. It can be an either ways breakout. So now what we can do is, we can simply go ahead and buy the combination of both calls and puts. So we can create an at the money straddle. So the strategy which we are talking about over here is a long straddle, wherein what we do is, we simply buy the call and put of the same strike price. So that is called as a long straddle. Now let's create a long straddle and let's try to analyze the strategy. So first we will go to Architect tool, so which is a custom strategy builder. Any of your strategy, it will help us in, I would say, architecting a payoff of it. So first, options, then we need to select a type of option. So let's say 15850 call, I have bought it. I will click on add button and I'll add another leg of mine, let's say 15850 put also, we will buy it at the same time. So this is the payoff which has been created, wherein the white dotted line is showing us today's end of the day PNL, orange line is showing us the PNL as on the expiry if we hold this particular strategy up till the expiry date. Now in this strategy, if we see today end of the day, so from 15800 up till the upside, which is 15900, only up till that level we are facing a loss. Nifty moving anywhere on the up or the downside, we are going to make a profit. So this type of strategy, which is a long straddle, can be executed when we expect a big move to happen on the up or the downside, wherein in this strategy your loss is also limited to the premium which you pay, the call and put premium. So even if you hold this strategy up till the expiry, your maximum loss is going to be 15,848 level, and the loss is going to be somewhere around 7,000. And today end of the day, if Nifty expires at 15,848, we are going to make a loss of 430 rupees roughly over here. So in this type of strategies, it is very prudent for, first thing is, move to happen. Like Nifty, if it ends up range bound, we will make a loss. And especially this type of strategies, if we hold it for a longer period of time, now what happens is, basically, as we had studied, the theta decay, the time value of money, is going to get decayed. So each and every passing day, this strategy will keep on decaying. So your maximum loss is going to be the premium which you paid. So there is no involvement of unlimited loss in this scenario. Further, the next time when you can initiate this particular strategy is, as we had discussed about the implied volatility, we had a video on implied volatility, and we had discussed how we can filter out the stocks where the stock reaches its lowest implied volatility point of last 180 days. So whenever, if a stock IV is going very low, let's say if it is going at 0th implied volatility percentile or falling below its historical volatility, okay, so in that case we are expecting the implied volatility of that stock to go up, alright. So we can also initiate this type of strategies when we are expecting the stocks IV to go up. So now let's say we can go around and just move the day slider, IV slider over here. So wherein in that case, whatever the current IV is, so if IV shoots up by 20% from here, so at the same level which was 15,848, we are making a PNL, a profit of 800 rupees. That is because the IV has gone up by 20%. So two times when you can initiate this strategy, the first one is when you are expecting a big move to happen, but you don't know the direction, but you know that the move is going to happen. The next time is basically when you expect the stock's IV to move up, to spike, to give that sudden spike so that you are going to earn on both call and put because you have bought it. So ultimately, if the IV rises, your premium will also go up along with it. Similarly, you can just change the strike prices out here and it will be created like a strangle. So now, market, as we all know, it is not going to move every day in such a huge points rally Nifty is going to give us. Alright, majority of the times, as we all know, that markets, they keep on oscillating in a range. So if we initiate this type of strategy, although the risk is limited, but ultimately net-net, you see, we are going to make a loss in this strategy. All is that so because theta is going to keep on decaying. And if the market doesn't move, we are going to make a loss in this strategy. So in a range bound or a flat market, an oscillating market, we can't initiate this type of strategy. So now, what is the strategy which we can initiate? So now, in an oscillating market, what we can do is, although it is a very high risk strategy, that is a disclaimer out here, but what we can do is we can simply just sell the call and the put option of the same strike price, so that will become like a straddle. So in an oscillating market, in a flat market, what we can do is we can try to initiate a short straddle. So this is a type of strategy, but although I wouldn't have recommended anyone because ultimately there is a very huge risk involved in such type of strategies because your profits are limited but your losses are unlimited. Now, as I said, the white dotted line is showing us today's end of the day PNL. We can just move around the day slider and just check the PNL as on day. So if I move the day slider to one day, it is showing us tomorrow's end of the day PNL, the white dotted line. So if Nifty bees in the range of 15,700 or I would say 720 onwards, 15,700 on and on the upside up till 15,970, 980 is the time when this strategy is going to give us a profit. If Nifty moves anywhere beyond the levels which I said, it is going to give us a loss. And ultimately the losses are uncapped over here. It will keep on increasing and increasing. So let's say if Nifty goes up till 15,000 level, we are going to make a loss of 32,000 in this particular strategy today, end of the day. Similarly, if we hold it up till the expiry, we are going to make a loss of 32,700. On the upside as well, our loss will keep on increasing once Nifty crosses that level of 15,970 onwards. This strategy will start to give us a loss, wherein Nifty goes anywhere above the level which I said, this strategy is going to give us a loss. And the bad part is, this type of strategies are executed these days a lot. But ultimately, if a very big move comes in, it might erase off our entire PNL. So now, the question is, when we are going to initiate this strategy? So I would say, when we are expecting the market to be very flat. The next thing is, now let's say, as we had discussed in IV, that IVs are an oscillating kind of a thing, wherein they are having mean reverting characteristics. So if a stock's IV is very high and you are expecting the IV to cool down, so you can initiate this type of strategy because you have shorted both calls and put of the same strike, wherein your PNL is going to get affected due to the IV crash. So you will earn call and put premium both only due to the IVs crashing of that particular instrument. But this is a very high risk strategy. So to reduce the risk, what we can do is we can convert this strategy, a short straddle, into a short strangle. So now, by creating a strangle, there are a lot of methodologies where participants follow. The first one might be the highest call and put over, wherein wherever the highest put OY is, we try to participate over there by shorting a put, and wherever the highest call OY is, because that are the levels which put writers and call writers are expecting not to be broken. So simply they will try to short a call and put of the same. Further, we can go ahead and try to, I would say, estimate the range of Nifty's ideal movement of period of next 1 week using the India VIX. So to create that, this idea is simple. What we can do is simply use the architect. We can go ahead and plot our strategy, let's say Nifty. And what we can do is, let's say 16,000 call option, we will sell it because we are not expecting Nifty to go beyond this. Similarly, we can go ahead and sell a put option as well of, let's say, 15,600. So now I have moved on this thing to a tabular view. So the difference between straddle and triangle is, first is the selection of strike prices. Then the other one is, you are going to get a much more safer range as compared to straddle. Because the thing is, in this particular strategy, as on the expiry, we are protected up till 15,580. So somewhere around 15,600 we are protected. And on the upside, we are protected up till 16,000 level. So we are getting a much more wider range as compared to the straddle. And also the risk would be very less, because if a fast move comes in, this strategy will have at least some buffer, but although even this strategy will have an unlimited risk. So now let's say that we are having an oscillating view on Nifty, but we want to participate into it, we want to make a profit out of it. But the thing is, straddle and strangles, they are very risky because they are carrying an unlimited risk along with them. So I don't want to participate in something wherein my entire PNL will get wiped off in a single move. So now what we can do is, I don't want to take an unlimited risk. So we can simply just buy the call option and put option. And this strategy would be an hedge strategy wherein it will be not giving us losses of an unlimited scenario. There would be losses in any strategy. It is not the case wherein you are going to make a profit everywhere. But the thing is, your losses would be capped at a point. So in this strategy, if we see, 2500 is our maximum loss in this strategy on the upside. Similarly, on the downside, at 15,692, somewhere around 15,700, our maximum loss will start coming in, and the loss is again going to be 2578. So your maximum profit is at 15,850 if Nifty expires over there. And then further we can go ahead and check the PNL chart of it. So now I would, if I was an option trader, I would have initiated something like an iron condor, because that will give us a much more safer strategy. It itself is a safer strategy, right, as compared to the unlimited loss scenarios. And also the fact of entire PNL getting wiped out is not an issue over here, at least. So yeah, I would say that was it from this video, wherein we can use the option architect tool, whatever our strategies are. So you can create your own strategy and analyze the PNL of it out here. And we can also play around with the IV skew over here. So the change in IV would be applicable to entire of the strategy as a whole, so that we can go and do some sensitive analysis as well. So whatever your strategy is, you can build it. You can check the PNL chart and take a well-calculated risk. Apart from that, thank you so much and stay tuned for the next video.